The Dog Pound will be marking for this week.
Orange and brown will be represented in full force here in Cleveland for this matchup between the Steelers and the Browns.
Yeah, and I think that makes it, you know, when you talk about 2 hours apart, we have a lot of fans that intertwine there. So when you get the fans really into the football game, a rivalry like this, Pittsburgh and Cleveland, it just gets more exciting, and I think it's going to show on the field.
Of course, in recent years, Pittsburgh has had by far the upper hand of this matchup, but I know Cleveland like to turn things around.
Well, I think the Cleveland Browns are doing what a lot of good teams do in a division when they're chasing the person in front of them. They want to be like the Pittsburgh Steelers. They want to be rough and tough, have an outstanding defense, and I'll tell you what it comes down to, can their quarterback play as well as Ben Roethlisberger?
It's been hard being a Browns fan with this rivalry here in recent years.
Yeah, you know what? But it still doesn't change. This will be the year. That's what all players always think. This is the year we unseat them and we become the kings of this division.
Offense lines up here. Now first and 10. Allen's going to secure a handoff. They tackle him for a loss.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Up in the pistol formation. From the gun. Working that left side. And he was wide open. He's going to be tackled right around the 46-yard line.
Well, I think early in the game, anytime you cross the 50-yard line, it just gives you confidence that what you're doing is going to work today. Let's see if they can take advantage of that and take it on down into the end zone.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Allen's going to receive the toss.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
The Steelers and the Browns. And this is a rivalry that maybe outside of Northeast Ohio and Western Pennsylvania, the rest of the country doesn't realize it. But there is a lot of really angry feelings between these two franchises and teams.
Well, that makes it some good football games, doesn't it? You have a little anger on each side. But, you know, when I think about this rivalry, I think about two teams playing each other in bad weather. Jim Brown running the football one side, and I know Mean Joe Green didn't play against him, but a great defensive player for the Pittsburgh Steelers. Just a lot of fun when you talk about these two teams.
These are two teams that are only separated by a two-hour drive, so they're always keeping an eye on one another.
They are, and for so many years, the Cleveland Browns want to be the first team that's talked about in this rivalry. The Steelers have dominated this for as long as I can remember. It's always been about the Steelers and not the Cleveland Browns.
Gets a handle that one to knock it away.
This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
Center. In trouble now.
Ben Roethlisberger for 250 pounds. What an athlete. He can throw the football extremely well, but he's also able to get out the pocket, or if you make him scramble, he'll hurt your defense.
Williams Williams is in the backfield.
On second and nine.
And Williams is going to take the handoff now. D'Angelo Williams with a nice piece of running on that play.
Well, the long run that time, and there's a lot of reasons why they got that long run. But the biggest one, the good blocking up front, but what patience for the running back. He did not panic because it took a while for that running lane to develop. When it did, he saw it, he hit it, and he used his talents to get down the field for a big game.
They motioned the receiver around to the other side. First and 10. Williams called on once again. And he is tackled down at the 38-yard line.
When you see long runs like that by a running back, a lot of things have to happen. Of course, he has good vision, and he has talent. But how about those blocks down the field, those blocks in the secondary? That's what creates the long run.
They send the tight end in motion. First down and 10. They hand it off to him again. Brought down just 2 yards shy of the first down marker.
When you run off tackle, one of the things you're looking for is for your tackle to make a good block. And then if you have a lead fullback, can he get past him and block the linebacker to free up the halfback so he can go in between them and get in the secondary and make a big play?
Second and 2. Bell's taking the handoff. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, proud of the line of scrimmage. And you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
The Browns defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Escaping the pressure, throws to the right. Under pressure, and incomplete.
Got to have good feet as a quarterback in today's game. And, that's always been the case. But when you get under pressure, you got to be able to move outside and see if you can make the play.
That kick is no good. No good. First down. Inaccurate with that one.
That was a deep pass that time against cover two, the two deep safeties, and you really want to throw the football down the middle or deep down the sidelines. That time the quarterback didn't do that, and that's why it was incomplete.
Out of the gun. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Batted away.
Good job by the cornerback. Reading the wide receiver. He is all over him, and it makes it easy for him to slot down the throw by the QB.
McGahee is in the backfield. Third and 10. Oh, almost caught.
That time the man-to-man coverage won. The quarterback had to make a perfect throw. He didn't. Incomplete pass.
First down here. With a screen set up here.
Got to get the defense a lot of credit here, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
There's Mike Tomlin on the sideline for the Steelers. He was hired at the age of 34 and really had immediate success there in Pittsburgh.
Mike Tomlin's one of those guys who can talk to you and put you at ease. He just has a way of talking to you that makes you feel comfortable. But make no doubt about it, on the football field and on the practice field, he is a tough guy, and that's the way his team plays.
Thank you. defensive backs out on the field for this one. Of course, it's a three and out.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
The punt team is in place and ready to perform. First down. This is a straight play all the way.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Nickel formation here for the defense. Allen's handed the football. And it's Ryan Clark who comes up to make the stop.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
After that pass carry, it's third and three. Allen's got it on the handoff. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
That's a bread and butter play by all offenses in the NFL. Get a few yards to get that first down.
Able to move the chains after that last run.
The run with it again.
Now the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
It's now second down. Play clock's running down.
Out of the shotgun.
Muscles through the defender. Gonna take off with it. Running play went for 11.
Well, good job that time by the defense, getting pressure on the quarterback, but you can't let him break the pocket. Look at this time, he breaks the pocket, he's looking down the field, nobody open, so he decides to run and picks up some big yards.
It'll be third down. Trying to beat the play clock. 15 minutes down, 45 minutes to go. Back after this word from your local station. On the way, third down. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. For the score, touchdown.
Well, when your offense goes out there and scores a touchdown to put you ahead, it's got to give a big lift to the defense. They got to get excited and go out there and hold that lead.
Count it. Browns ready to take it to the opponent. Taken down well short of the 20. Let's mark him at the 15. Williams is in the backfield. Challenging the defenders to the right side. Incomplete, almost intercepted.
Just stick the football on him. When you see a receiver run a route like this, they're going to the corner, drive it, throw it on a line drive, so that way there can't be a mistake.
Second down following that incompletion.
Williams down to the 15.
Not much the offense can do in a situation like this. Third and long, what you probably will have to do is either surprise him with the run or throw it short and hope somebody can make a play and pick up a first down.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Bell's going to secure the handoff. Of course, it's going to be three and out. They're set to run it away now. He's going to try and return this punt. The tackle was made. Comes out of the nickel. First and 10. Quarterback. Quick toss to the outside. Gains 11.
Well, when you give up a running play that's long, you got to say this to the defense. You did not hustle enough. If you are hustling, when that running back makes that secondary move, you got to be there to make the tackle. Swarm the football, that's how you stop long runs.
First and 10.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Second down. Stacked up at that point. The slot. They better hurry to get the snap. Incomplete.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense at time.
They head to the line. Looking to scramble. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out, incomplete.
Jim, that was really a terrific job by the quarterback. The pocket is breaking down, and look at that. He just steps up, moves out. Good job of keeping the play alive.
Second down after the incompletion. Here's the handoff and no running. Running to the left side.
Well, we're trying to tackle this guy. His legs are the size of a refrigerator, so hard to wrap him up. That's why he picked up the big game.
Williams is in the backfield. Roethlisberger standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. He'll fire it out to the left. The Steelers get a first down.
All the quarterbacks in the NFL, they'd all be great if they had all day to throw like this. When you give an average quarterback this kind of time, he turns into a great quarterback.
Brown's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Roethlisberger's turning to look downfield now after selling the play fake. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Quarterback's best friend. Throw a short pass and see it turn into big yards. What a job that time by the pass receiver. Catches the short pass and picks up big yards afterwards. Nice job.
First down here after the completion. Roethlisberger's dropping back the throw once again. Makes the catch in open space. Good piece of tackle. This is turning into quite a drive, Bill.
Nice job, Jim, by the offensive coordinator, just mixing the plays up and keeping the defense off balance.
First down following the long play. Williams going to secure the football on the toss.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Second and goal. He is in for the touchdown.
Good job by the offense. They get in there. They tie this game up. Now we'll see if the defense can take advantage of that momentum and keep it on their side.
Inside of the upright. The Browns are back deep, ready to return. Setting up in the pistol on this play.
Let's go.
And 10. Play fake here. Almost intercepted.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage that time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
Allen's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Good running. Here's the handoff.
An off-tackle run is a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker.
The Browns will go with the pistol on this play. Third and five. Ball's incomplete. Fourth down coming up. Looks like we'll go three and out on this series. They're in punting formation.
Punt it away now.
He wants to return this one. Nice tackle. Williams is in the backfield. And Williams is going to take the handoff now.
The off-tackle run. It's just what it says it is. You're going to read the tackle's block and decide whether you're going to go inside or outside. Usually, this is the first running play every team puts in their offense when they go to training camp.
And we reach the two-minute warning.
Now we reach the two-minute warning here in the second quarter. Williams lined up in a single back formation. Looks to his left. Catch is made. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
The quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple of yards.
The Browns lined up in the nickel. Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
To the line of scrimmage. First down. They'll go shotgun here. Looking to the right side and throwing. Slips right through his fingertips.
These receivers in the NFL, they are so good now. Anytime you see a drop pass, it's almost always the one reason. They took their eyes off the football before it got to them.
Offense lines up here. Second down and 10. He has the grab.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches. One of these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Matthew is lined up now as a slot receiver. Drop back, shotgun formation. The throw to the left. That pass picked off by Antoine Winfield.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception. Coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Game on first down. He makes the catch. He's brought to a halt.
Getting harder and harder in the NFL to score when you're this close to the goal line. So what will the offense do? They better be creative. That's all I know.
And now they'll try over again on second down. Bells. He's in for the touchdown.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
David Akers lining up for the kickoff.
And a touchback.
First and 10. And he's taken down.
Well, the offensive line's not good enough just to stop the pass rush, and you got to help him out. How do you do that? Well, you keep the tight end in, let him be an extra blocker, and you tell your running backs to help out too, blocking some of these defensive linemen.
The Browns in the pistol. Up the middle. Gains a few. The Steelers have to take their final timeout. That's it. Third down here. Offense trying to pick up the first.
Third and long.
Trying to find an open man. Incompletion there. Just not quite able to get the feet down.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
Should be a routine punt. Good catch signal.
Got the hand up into the sky.
The Steelers will look to get set. It's been a close game so far. The score is 14-7. Ready for intermission.
First, one more play.
Roethlisberger takes the snap from the gun. Launches it down the field. Almost intercepted that time. That does it for the first half. Browns trail in this one. We're back here now in this one, where the Steelers are leading by 7. Browns ready to take it to the opponent. Across the 20 and tackled at the 21. First down all the way. Quarterback tosses it to the outside. Gains 13.
That's what you want to do, just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
And Williams is lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. First and 10. Staying with the running game on first down.
You cannot let offensive players get up the sideline of the NFL. That's where a lot of big plays are made. The defensive end that time, well, he was on the end, and he stopped that run for very little gain.
Catch is made. He's brought down.
Nice catch by the receiver, but he still doesn't get a first down.
Wide receivers stacked up on this play. Third and 7. Had it.
Look, receivers where the rules that you can't touch them, there's no excuse for dropping the football.
Kapanos out for the punt. Looking to make a difference. Shakes off the tackle. Shakes off the tackle. Gains 18. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, I think we know all the players on their team are important. But let's be serious. Every team has three or four guys that they built their franchise around. This guy is hurt, and this, if he's hurt, this is a tremendous blow to the chance of this football team.
Let's go.
Team. Let's go.
First and 10. The ball is out. This one's going back the other way. The defense comes up with the big play, the hit, and the recovery of the football.
Yeah, they sure did. They got so much speed on the defensive side, and that speed, when you think about it, it gets more people around the football. It helps you deliver the hit even harder, and that's why they got the turnover. Great job.
Defense with plenty of bodies in the box here on this play. First and 10. He's scrambling down. Browns in the slot. Second and 10. Going off tackle here. And he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap. And they hold that run to a short game.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Bell's hand at the football. The tackle is made, and that's a three-and-out series for the offense. Steelers lining up for the field goal. He converts here on the field goal try.
Well, you come out there on the field as a defense. The offense has great field position. You got to give them something different. The defense did. They stopped them, and they gave up the field goal.
Tackle just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Face first down. The give. They're going to run it right. Gets past the first wave. He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line.
Well, when your team is behind, what do you do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
First down here after the run. We'll stay on the ground on first down.
When your defensive tackles are playing really well, it is amazing what it can do for a defense. That time they stopped the inside run, and it just lets the outside defenders and everybody else run free because of how well they are playing.
Offense lines up here. The play clock's running down. He takes the snap from the shotgun. Trying to work that left side. Throws it incomplete in the double coverage.
Terrible job by the offensive line. Your quarterback needs more time than that. Another incompletion.
Quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Reaches in, and that pass is in.
Good job by the corner that time, knocking the football down on the throw down the field by the quarterback. That will go down as a pass defense by him. Good job. Never take it for granted. When you're trying to field goal, a lot of things can go wrong. But good execution that time by the offense, and a good kick. 3 points.
That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. Is in the backfield. First and 10. Roethlisberger going down the field.
It takes really good corners to play a defense where you challenge the wide receivers and just play them man-to-man coverage. I don't think this defense has that kind of quality corners.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
Quarterback drops back, play action. Here's the long throw by Roethlisberger.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
First down after the big play.
D'Angelo Williams. They got him down there.
Closer defense gets to the end zone. Their backs are against it. The tougher they get. But that time, the offense still able to pick up a few yards on an inside run.
That'll be second and four after the running play. Fake, setting up screen. Complete. Dragged to the ground. Looks like he's still about a yard short of the first.
Again, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Third down on the way.
Bill running off the toss. Powers his way across. Touchdown.
This offense, they are so aggressive. I love them, man. Even though they had the lead, they kept pressing the issue, and they got another touchdown to increase that lead.
Steelers setting up here for the kickoff.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20 to mark him down at the 19.
Split backfield here.
First and 10. Allen's got him on the handoff. He's brought down at the 25-yard line.
Good job that time by the offense. Allen one gets him a few yards.
This will be second down.
Going to secure the handoff. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
Nothing fancy about that, but it's a good run. Gets a first down. Now the offense has three more chances.
New set of downs now. Picking up the first on the ground.
Allen's going to take the handoff now.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
The defense comes out of the dime. Second and five, gets it again here. He's brought to the foul.
Now you know why guys like Vince Wilfork are so important to the middle of defenses. You need a big run stopper to stop these runs right up the middle. You either need a big run stopper or some really big linebackers to stop those runs up inside.
15 minutes to go. We'll return after this message and a word from your local station.
Moreno lined up in the backfield.
We are back for the start of the fourth quarter. And they go back to the ground, and he's tackled
at the 34-yard line. When you have a defense that's not playing good techniques, they're selling out, overplaying plays. Well, you run the counter runs to counteract what they're doing on the defensive side.
Second and four. Greg Little with the grab.
When you can't hit the quarterback to put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time, throws it down the field for another completion.
That reception gave them the first down. From the shotgun.
There is a flag down.
Ball's going to be incomplete. A hit knocked the ball out. The defense accepts the penalty.
Still first down.
To go. And the tackle is made right around the 39-yard line. Moreno shifted from running back to a receiver in the slot. From the gun. He's looking to the right here on this throw.
Well, they complete the pass to him, but doesn't get the first down. Sooner or later, you got to throw him down the field.
Third and nine. Just had to avoid the sack. Offense lines up here. Quarterback taking the snap from the shotgun. They'll turn it over on downs.
Situations like this sometimes can cost you the game. You're down in the second half. Why would you go for it on fourth down in this situation? You don't get it, that decision might cost you this football game.
Ben Roethlisberger takes a look down from under center. Play action. Getting sacked.
It is truly a bonus. You can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback, and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker.
Quarterback one more time. Can they get another sack right here?
Well, that was a nice run that time off tackle. And listen, this is a bread and butter play in the NFL. It's about power running. Can your offensive tackle make the block to free up that running back so he has a chance to get that secondary and make a nice run out of it?
Offense lines up here. 16. Screen. Inhales the pass. That's a good tackle. And that's a quick three and out.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
first down coming up. To the ground here. They knock them down behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Second and 11. Looking across the middle.
Oh, good job by the linebacker knocking that pass down that time. All he did was watch the eyes of the quarterback, and he reacted. It put him in good position, and he knocks the football down.
Pick up a first down on this series. Pat McAfee now ready to punt. They bring him to the turf. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down and he's in pain.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
First down, offense ready for the snap. The quarterback will hand it off. He is tackled at the 40-yard line.
You're an offensive lineman, and you can line up and just run the football straight ahead and pick up those kind of yards. You are going to get into the head of the defense. You're basically saying we're tougher than you are, and we're just going to come right at you.
The defense comes out in the middle.
Second down and four.
Williams, he's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
How about the defensive line? Getting that penetration, getting off the football at the snap, and getting it done, getting in the backfield and making that tackle.
It's third down coming up. Bells taking the handoff. The tackle was made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down. Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I just spoke with a Browns official. Sounds like it's just a minor issue, and he'll be back on the field shortly.
The quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time.
Oh, what a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving him into the ground.
Here we have second down.
On the spot. That's Troy Polamalu.
That was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
Setting up with a pistol on this play.
Out of the shotgun formation. And the tackle was made at the 48-yard line.
The Browns lined up in the pistol.
Second and five.
We'll go ground. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Nice job that time. the run play gets the first down, you move those chains. Hey, it's kind of fun to watch a team tough enough and patient enough to run the football to get these first downs instead of throwing it all the time.
Gets away from the pressure. And they tackle him. They're at the 34.
Last play before the 2 minute warning.
We've hit the 2 minute warning in the second half.
Anytime you picked up a couple first downs, here's what happens. The defense starts to doubt what they're doing, but maybe more importantly, it gets those big boys over there tired.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. On first down, it's back to the ground game.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just put his big butt right into the ground.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Trying to make something happen.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
First and goal. Moreno's hand at the football. A tackle behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Quarterback coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. Challenging the defenders to the right side, off the mark.
Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
You're taking touchdown. This
drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Third and goal from the 10. Did not get both feet down.
This drive's coach is crazy. They get a wide receiver open down the field on a post route, and what happens? The quarterback just overthrows it.
Coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. It's fourth down, and it's goal to go. Touchdown, and this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
This is why a head coach gets paid so much money. You get in situations like this, they have to make the call on fourth and goal. He goes for it, and they get it.
And the extra point is good. The Steelers set to return the kick. No returns. The ball's coming out to the 20. They run the counter play. Great screen.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
Williams in the backfield, single back set. It's a second and four. The quarterback hands it off on the draw. They knock him down, and he's still 2 yards short of the first.
Hard sometimes as an offensive coordinator to call plays to catch the defense off guard when you're winning and it's late in the game. So they played it very predictable there. The defense was ready, nowhere to go.
Browns, a receiver in the slot. Third and two, staying on the ground. to the 35.
That's an excellent job. Just getting enough yardage to get the first down, move those chains, and keep this offense going.
Game has come to an end. It was a good one throughout, hotly contested right down to the wire.